I now give the floor to the representative of the major group on local communities.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. A pleasant day to everybody. I'm representing the Community Practitioners Platform. So the Community Practitioners Platform on Resilience was established in 2010 and served as a global mechanism for organized communities living and working in disaster-prone urban and rural areas to play an active role in implementing the Sendai framework and drive disaster and climate resilience agenda at local, national, and global level. Grassroots organizations possess unique organizing capacities, participatory action tools, local data, knowledge and resilience practices that are missing among government and other stakeholders, but are essential to advance risk-informed development and targets set in Sendai framework. We need a paradigm shift in our thinking about risk, bridging the gap between disasters, response, and recovery at the long-term planning and preparedness. Risk-informed development calls for community resilience building approach that is concerned not only disaster and emergency response capacities, but targets the underlying factors of vulnerability which concern socioeconomic inequality and poverty all the way to the household level. The Community Practitioners Platform has actively distributed to implementing an inclusive bottom-up and proof-poor approach to risk-informed development and resilience building. Our members have held capacity and awareness workshop at the Sendai Framework on Disaster Risk Reduction across Latin America, Asia, and Africa to build community capacities on disaster risk reduction. Women have organized around community resilience funds, a tool that serves as an emergency fund, a collective mechanism to avert risk to livelihoods and platform to exchange resilience communities, practices, and innovation in 24 countries. Engaging countries across the world, we have conducted 100 risk mapping exercises in Latin America, Asia, Africa, and even trained other stakeholders, including local governments and risk governance and resource management that are inclusive of grassroots communities. Our members collaborate with national and regional disaster risk reduction authorities and local government to advance achievement of Target E in Central America. We work in CIPRIDANAC to include grassroots women's knowledge and develop and implementing regional disaster risk reduction strategies. In the Philippine grassroots organization, work to sensitize local government at the same day framework for DRR and its target. Meanwhile, leaders in Indonesia are actively participating in government and consultation on national strategy development. The Community Practitioners Platform hosted a global grassroots academy during the Global Platform on Disaster Risk Reduction preparatory days that brought together grassroots women leaders from 12 countries to share the practices in community resilience building and develop and collective advocacy. And develop collective messages in relation to scaling community practitioners' effort and partnership under Sendai Framework for Disaster Risk Reduction Implementation. We have several priorities. We have priority one, understanding risk. The community risk mapping is a participatory tool providing critical information on vulnerabilities and resilience priorities, but also community capacity and strength, which should ground inclusive and participatory risk management plans. This mapping and enumeration tools serve to develop community resilience strategy and agenda. We call for the resilience agenda to be institutionalized, part of disaster risk reduction governance process and for formalization of the rules in the effort to understand community risk. Priority two is strengthening disaster risk governance, institutional actor change regularly that organize women and communities remain grassroots. Women and organizing local-to-local dialogues and other processes, demonstrating through partnership how community engagement in government resilience plans can support effective delivery of resilience targets. These dialogues also serve as a space for community leaders to present community resilience priorities. We call on recognition and institutionalization of the role of community-based organization in disaster risk reduction for meaningful engagement of community organization in disaster risk reduction making processes. Priority three, investing in disaster risk reduction for resilience. Grassroots women invest their fiscal and social capital, our human and economic resources to building community resilience. We ask the government to allocate direct funding, 5% of risk finance to grassroots women-led organizations so we can build our practices and scale up our actions. Thank you.